President Trump offering no signs of conceding, pushing ahead with legal challenges, golfing over the weekend as the race was projected, and today he fired his Defense Secretary Mark Esper in a tweet. Here's our chief White House correspondent, Jonathan Carl.
The only glimpses we've seen of Donald Trump since Joe Biden was projected president-elect came over the weekend at his golf course. He is still not willing to accept defeat, fighting his battle in court and on Twitter. But today he also announced on Twitter he had terminated his Defense Secretary Mark Esper. Esper was with the president during the infamous photo op at St. John's Church, where protesters were cleared out with tear gas and flashbang grenades. He then infuriated the president by suggesting he would object to an order to deploy the military to crack down on protesters.
Mark Esper? Did you call him Esper? Oh, okay. Some people call him Esper.
Esper hated the idea he was seen as a yes man, telling the Military Times in an interview published just after he was fired, "Who's pushed back more than anybody? Name another cabinet secretary that's pushed back. Have you seen me on stage saying, under the exceptional leadership of blah, 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 we have blah, 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 blah?" It comes as Team Trump is challenging the election results in several states.
This election is not over. Far from it.
But they presented no credible evidence of vote fraud, as the Republican lieutenant governor of Georgia told CNN today.
We've not had any sort of credible incidents raised to our level yet.
Most Republicans in Congress are staying on the sidelines, not yet acknowledging that Joe Biden won, but also not repeating the president's false allegations.
The president has every right to look into allegations and to request recounts under the law.
On Twitter, Vice President Pence proclaimed, "It ain't over till it's over." But notably, even he did not repeat the president's claims of voter fraud. One prominent Republican who says it actually is over, former President George W. Bush. He called to congratulate both President-elect Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala Harris, saying, quote, "Though we have political differences, I know Joe Biden to be a good man who has won his opportunity to lead and unify our country."
And John, we've counted on your reporting throughout all of this. What are you hearing from your sources tonight? Where is the president on all of this tonight?
David, he is digging in. He is determined to pursue every possible legal action to overturn the unofficial election results. I think he is still a long way away from either conceding the election or recognizing Joe Biden as president-elect.
All right, John Carl with us here all weekend and here again tonight. Thank you, John.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.